My name is Eli. I'm in my late 20s. I love rock climbing, biking, and hiking. And also, I have a broken back. I learned earlier this year because I had had a couple of months of chronic low back pain. And I go, finally, to get some x-rays done. And as it turns out, my back, specifically my L5 vertebra, had shifted over my sacrum more than 50%, which is really bad. As a diagram, I have these two mugs to represent my vertebra. So healthy vertebra kind of sit perfectly over each other with something called an intervertebral disc that separates them. So my L5, my lowest vertebra, is doing this on my sacrum or my pelvis. Not a good thing. It's a condition known as spondylolisthesis, and the prognosis for people in my position is generally very little. You can either do physical therapy that will keep the slip from getting worse, or you can have spinal fusion, which is where they generally take hardware to pull everything back into place, fix it together, and then they actually use parts of your own bone material to graft those two pieces of bone that were originally autonomous into one mega bone. That's spinal fusion. And quite frankly, it's really scary. It comes with a lot of risks. It's a dangerous surgery. It's expensive and it has a really long recovery. And as someone who rock climbs, all of those things scare me. I've been researching this for months. In fact, I was scheduled to get a mega bone surgery. And at the last minute, I learned that there is a non-surgical approach that has successfully reversed spondylolisthesis in a couple of people. So this is a vlog, it's a real journey. I have met the practitioner. It's actually a chiropractor in Georgia who developed this method, has published numerous case studies of successful reversal, and I am going to videotape my own experience going through this. So if you or a loved one need spinal fusion, specifically for spondylolisthesis, this video is for you. It's a really common condition, especially as we age. And if this has any chance of working, that's awesome. That's super cool. Nobody wants megabone, to be quite frank. Sorry for those of you who have megabone. But if it's avoidable, I'm here to find out. Hey, y'all. It is Wednesday, day one of traction therapy. I'm outside of the building right now, as you can see. A little nervous because this guy was honest and said that the Georgia practitioner who came up with this is the expert. This guy's not the expert, but he has been talking to that instructor in Georgia for the past 2 days, and we're gonna try to do every single thing that he says works to reverse spondylolisthesis. So fingers crossed, I would love to get back into bouldering soon. So I am leaving. Day one. I thought we were starting the treatment today, but Dr. Ju is interested in doing a lot more imaging, so we took probably 12 different x-rays in all different angles. I also have scoliosis in my upper and lower spine, and so his specialty is scoliosis, so he's trying to be mindful of the curvatures that I already have while performing the traction therapy. So I'm coming back tomorrow.
It is the first week of traction therapy. I'm definitely nervous. I spoke with Curtis Fedorchuk, who is the guy who pioneered this with a clinic in Georgia. He had a lot of confidence, actually, in the outcomes from this treatment. This might be an alternative to spinal fusion, which nobody wants. It blows my mind that when I talked to Curtis and he said he has done this for hundreds of patients and he has data, patient information of outcomes of reversal for hundreds of people, why is this not the standard of care? And even all the spinal surgeons that I've spoken with understand that you kind of run into a lifetime of additional challenges once you start fusing vertebrae together. So I'm excited to do everything right, do all my PT. I'm a rock climber, so it hurts my heart to have to stop bouldering for some time, but here's hoping I come out the other side even stronger. Yep.
Okay, so now is the official first day of traction therapy. We're gonna do a Skype or Zoom or some kind of virtual call with Curtis Fedorchuk simultaneously to make sure that the traction table is set up and that we can replicate what he did in his office with live imaging. Nervous, but excited. Hope there's some relief. Okay, so we officially did our start, which was mostly just getting the table configured. They pulled me apart on the table a little bit, and that felt nice. It's definitely a learning curve. I knew for a fact these guys had never done this before, but they did have Dr. Curtis on the line the entire time, remoting in. So yeah, I do feel some immediate relief, but that's not the healing. The healing is consistently trying to shift things back into place, engaging all of the muscles in my abdomen and my back to hold them there. So now I have to deal with some crap with insurance to get them to cover this, because they really want me to pay for surgery instead. So yeah, keep you guys posted.